Good morning, students. From your textbook, Footprints Without Feet, we are doing chapter number 6, The Making of a Scientist, written by Robert W. Peterson. In our first part, we read that how the mother and son were companion to each other, and mother made sure that she is going to provide all the things that were necessary to encourage him in his interest in learning. So she got telescopes, microscopes, cameras, various materials, equipments to make sure that he has one or the other thing that was interested, that would encourage him into learning. And he was indeed a very curious student and had a bright mind. So the mother gave him a children's book named The Travel of Monarch X. And we have already learned that how Ebright had collected 25 species of butterfly in his hometown, that is Reading in Pennsylvania. So before his interest in butterfly could die out, the mother gave him a book, and the name of the book was The Travel of Monarch X. And when he went through this book, a whole new world of science was open in front of him. Now let's continue with the line-by-line explanation of the chapter. At the end of the book, readers were invited to help study butterfly migrations. They were asked to tag butterflies for research by Dr. Frederick A. Urquhart of the University of Toronto, Canada. Ebright's mother wrote to Dr. Urquhart, and soon Ebright was attaching light adhesive tags to the wings of monarchs. Anyone who found a tagged butterfly was asked to send the tag to Dr. Urquhart. So what was the book? The book name was The Travels of Monarch X. So this book was given to Ebright by his mother. So at the end of the book, what was invited? The readers were invited to help study butterfly migration. Migration is what? Migration is flying from one place to another. That is a seasonal movement. So the readers were invited to study the butterfly migration. And how they were supposed to do? They were asked to tag butterflies for research by Dr. Frederick A. Urquhart of the University of Toronto, Canada. So Dr. Frederick Urquhart, he is from University of Toronto. He was doing a research. Research means systematic investigation to establish facts. He was doing a research, and he asked the readers of that book that you are going to tag the butterfly. If you are into catching a butterfly, you will tag that butterfly. Tag means to label for identification. That is to track the movement of the butterfly. And what next is to be done when it is tagged? Ebright's mother wrote to Dr. Urquhart, and soon Ebright was attaching light adhesive tags to the wings of monarch. So Ebright's mother wrote to Dr. Urquhart regarding what? That he was into collection of butterflies. And then when Ebright learned that such a research is going on the study of butterfly migration, he also started doing what? He also started attaching the butterflies, the wings of the monarch butterfly. And how he used to do was attaching light adhesive tags. Adhesive means sticking substance. So light adhesive thing he was using, that could be stick on the surface of the wings of monarch, and he started tagging monarch butterflies. Anyone who found a tag butterfly was asked to send the tag to Dr. Urquhart, and whoever catches the butterfly, whoever means the readers of that book, especially the book. So if they were into collection of butterflies, or were into tagging butterflies, or collecting a tagged butterfly, they were asked that those tagged butterflies are to be sent to Dr. Urquhart, who was into doing a research on the migration of butterflies. The butterfly collecting season around Reading lasts 6 weeks in late summer. If you are going to chase them one by one, you won't catch very many. So the next step for Ebright was to raise a flock of butterflies. He would catch a female monarch, take her eggs and raise them in his basement through their life cycle from egg to caterpillar to pupa to adult butterfly. Then he would tag the butterfly's wings and let them go. For several years, his basement was home to thousands of monarchs in different stages of development. So butterfly collecting season in Reading, that is the hometown of Richard Ebright, was 6 weeks in late summer. So he started chasing them one by one so that he could tag and he could send it to Dr. Urquhart. But then catching one at the time will not be sufficient enough. It would consume a whole lot of time and he would not be able to collect that many. So the best thing he did was he started raising a flock of butterflies. How he started raising a flock of butterflies? He caught hold of a female butterfly. He took the eggs of the female butterfly and then he raised them in his basement, that is the cellar, through their life cycle. Life cycle is what? Series of changes in the life of an organism, that is including the reproduction also. So he started raising those eggs and that eggs turned to caterpillar, to pupa and to adult butterfly. Then he would tag those butterflies and let them go. For several years he collected those in the basement and thousands of monarchs in different stages of their development. Students, this is the life cycle of a butterfly. Butterflies develop through a process called metamorphosis. This is a Greek word that means transformation or change in shape. So the life cycle of butterfly is from the egg that is laid on the leaves or of the plant, that eggs change to caterpillar, to pupa, and then to adult butterfly. Eventually, I began to lose interest in tagging butterflies. It's tedious and there's not much feedback, Ebright said. In all the time I did it, he laughed, only two butterflies I had tagged were recaptured and they were not more than 75 miles from where I lived. So Ebright says that eventually, that means in a little while, finally, the interest in tagging butterflies was lost. Why? It's tedious, it is monotonous, it is very tiring, it's boring, and there's not much feedback, and the feedback from the response to an experiment was also not there. The response to that was also not there. In all the time I did it, only two butterflies I had tagged were recaptured. So thousands of monarchs that he had raised in his basement and tagged them, of those thousands, only two were recaptured. Only two were caught. Only two were taken by the people. And they were not more than 75 miles from where I lived. And he lived in Reading. So in Reading, 75 miles only, these people had caught only two out of those thousand. So he says that I lost interest in tagging butterflies. Then in the 7th grade, he got a hint of what real science is when he entered a county science fair and lost. It was really a sad feeling to sit there and not get anything while everybody else had won something, Ebright said. His entry was slides of frog tissues, which he showed under a microscope. He realized the winners had tried to do real experiments, not simply make a neat display. So when he was in 7th grade, he did what? He understood what actually real science is, why he had participated in a county science fair. County means that is a territorial division, or you can say a chief unit of local administration. So he participated in the science fair, but then he lost. He did not win anything. It was really a sad feeling to sit there and not get anything while everybody else had won something. Now, Ebright said what? That sitting over there in a science fair and seeing people winning was really sad because he did not get any award, he did not win anything. His entry was slides of frog tissues, which he showed under a microscope. What he exhibited in that science fair? He exhibited that under a microscope how the frog tissues can be seen. That was his entry. That is, the slide of frog tissues was his entry for that competition, for that science fair. And he showed those frog tissues under a microscope. He realized the winners had tried to do real experiments, not simply make a neat display. Now, when he lost, he realized that what actually these science experiments are. He realized that those winners, they were doing real something. They were doing some invention, some discovery related to science. And that was the reason that they won an award. But Ebrard lost it because it was just an exhibition of a frog tissue under a microscope. So he realized that what the real science, actual science is. Already, the competitive spirit that drives Richard Ebrard was appearing. I knew that for the next year's fair, I would have to do a real experiment, he said. The subject I knew most about was the insect work I had been doing in the past several years. So this competitive spirit, that is, competitive means involving competition, this competitive spirit was aroused in Richard Ebrard when he appeared for the science fair and lost it. And he knew that when next year, when I'm again going to come in this county science fair, I need to do some real experiment that can attract the judges over there, the people over there, something that nobody else has done. And he knew what? He knew that his most interest has been in the insects. He had been doing his studies for several years in insects. So he thought that the best thing, the subject that he would choose for the coming year or the upcoming year for the science fair would be related to insects. So he wrote to Dr. Ugrihat for ideas, and back came a stack of suggestions for experiments. Those kept Ebrard busy all through high school and led to prize projects in county and international science fairs. So he wrote to Dr. Ugrihat, and he sent a whole lot of list of ideas to Ebrard for the experiments that he can do for his county science fair. And because he had got a whole lot of suggestions from doctors, so he thought he started working on the same. And that kept him busy in the high school also. And he won many, many prizes in the county fairs as well as international science fairs, as he was all into doing experiments and doing some studies related to same. So he won many prizes. For his 8th grade project, Ebrard tried to find the cause of a viral disease that kills nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. Ebrard thought the disease might be carried by a beetle. He tried raising caterpillars in the presence of beetles. I didn't get any real results, he said, but I went ahead and showed that I had tried the experiment. This time, I won. So when Ebrard was in his 8th grade, he did what? He tried to find the cause of a viral disease. Viral disease, that is the virus that kills nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. So caterpillars, we have already learned, is a stage in the life cycle of a butterfly. And we are talking over here a butterfly, that is monarch. So he started doing this project that a viral disease is killing a monarch caterpillar every few years. Ebrard thought the disease might be carried by a beetle. So he was of the idea that this virus is coming from a beetle. Beetle, you know, is an insect. He tried raising caterpillars in the presence of beetles. So he started working on the same, that whether this virus is coming from the beetles. So he started raising caterpillars and beetles together. He tried raising in the presence of beetles only those caterpillars. I didn't get any real results, he said. So he was not able to get the connection whether the virus was coming from a beetle to a monarch caterpillar, and that is why they were killed. So he was not able to get some fruitful result whether this theory was right or wrong. But I went ahead and showed that I had tried the experiment. This time I won. So he went ahead in this county science fair, and he showed that this is the experiment I have done. I have done an experiment that I raised the caterpillars in the presence of beetles to check whether a virus from the beetles is killing the caterpillars. So this experiment he showed in the science fair, and this time because of his experiment he won the award. Though the results were not there, but still he won the award for his curiosity towards science and his study and his research into the same. The next year, his science fair project was testing the theory that viceroy butterflies copy Muna. So the next year science fair, he took a topic, and the topic was, the study was what, that the viceroy butterflies imitate the monarch butterflies, they copy the monarch butterflies. The theory was that viceroys look like monarchs because monarchs don't taste good to birds. Now the theory is what? The theory that the viceroys copy monarch butterfly, the theory is that viceroy and monarch, there is not much differentiation when it comes to their pattern. There's not much differentiation between the both. So it's very difficult to distinguish between a viceroy and a monarch butterfly. But then monarch butterflies are not taste, does not taste good to the birds. Birds do not like eating monarch butterflies. Viceroy, on the other hand, do taste good to birds, but then birds like eating viceroy butterflies. So the more they look like monarchs, the less likely they are to become a bird dinner. So this is the project. The project was what, that the viceroy butterflies copy monarch. Why? Because the bird like eating viceroy butterflies, but not the monarch butterflies. So the viceroys copy and imitate the monarchs so that they do not become a victim or a dinner to a bird. So this is what he did, an experiment, and this he took for the science fair. Abra's project was to see whether in fact birds would eat monarchs. So his project was to check out whether the birds like eating monarch or will they eat the monarch butterflies. He found that a starling would not eat ordinary bird food. So the starling is a bird. So he found out that like ordinary birds, a starling does not eat ordinary food. Unlike any other bird, starling does not eat ordinary food. It would eat all the monarchs it could get. So the starling is a bird that would eat the monarch butterflies. Abright said later, research by other people showed that viceroys probably do not copy the monarch. And in fact, other than Abright, many other people have done the same research. And in fact, they have led to the conclusion that yes, viceroys do copy or imitate the monarch butterflies. This project was placed first in the zoology division and third overall in the county science fair. So this project that viceroys copy monarch and the birds would eat monarch or not. This project won an award and he got a third position in the county science fair. Image of a monarch butterfly and a viceroy butterfly.